For the Southern California Prep Insider, I'm Keith Wolder here for another edition of the LA City Section Lacrosse Podcast, presented to you by the United States Marine Corps. We're here at El Camino Real, an unfortunate game for the Conquistadors. They drop it 9-4 to Palisades, and what a game it was. We'll get to that in just a moment, but first we got to get to the top nine for the boys' side, folks. We know you've been waiting for it all week long. There's been some movement in the boys' top 10, some teams sliding down, and Palisades remaining at the number one spot on top. So let's get right into it. Number one, Palisades, as usual. Then we go Hamilton, Birmingham. Then we got Voss at four. Then North Valley Military Institute over El Camino Real. El Camino Real, number six in the poll. Then we have Hollywood at seven, Westchester at eight, and Jordan at nine. Not much of a change with the bottom three teams, rather. But some changes in the middle there. El Camino Real slides to six. So Palisades, they keep on proving, folks, why they are the number one team in the section. Win after win after win. They played Hamilton last week, and they were dominating throughout. It was not even close, folks. Holding the Yankees to just five goals. Usually the Yankees, they're a really high-scoring offense, and Palisades, their defense, just shut them down, essentially. So when you can dominate in section like Palisades has, you're going to stay number one all year long. Hamilton, they're number two in the section, not just because they competed well against Palisades, but also they have a head-to-head win over Birmingham. A key game, though, this Wednesday they'll play against Birmingham, so that'll decide who is number two in the section. And speaking about Birmingham, the number three team, they had a big 15-7 win over Voss. Meanwhile, Hamilton won 20-17 over Voss. So the Patriots, they come into this game tomorrow on Wednesday with a better win over Voss, 15-7 versus 20-17. So that could potentially be a factor, but Hamilton already has the win on the year. So we'll see exactly who wins, but right now both teams have a lot of scoring potential. And both teams, they played as best as they could against Palisades, but it's really hard to tell right now between 2 and 3 right there. Meanwhile, Voss and NVMI leapfrog ECR. Voss has competed with these top teams, but they may have lost, but they've looked good in the other games that they have played this year. ECR, they just have two wins on the year. We know Garrett Kim can score, one of the better scorers in the section. We mentioned in every single podcast, Adams Cuevas as well. But here's the thing, folks. ECR, even in their non-conference schedule, they need to win ball games, and they just have not done that. So I think that they have a game against Simi Valley coming up. That'll be a huge game for them to kind of get them back into the swing of things. But it's been a difficult year for ECR. There are a lot of new players in the program, so they're trying to learn along with the rest of the section. So ECR, once they get a quality non-conference win in some of the rest of their schedule, they have a couple games left. Maybe they'll come back into the top four. Who knows? But right now, they'll stay at six because of their overall record. NVMI, they've beaten Westchester, Jordan, and Hollywood numerous times, which is why I have them above ECR, because in section they have a better record. But that said, they haven't played as well as they could against some of these non-conference teams. Right now, if they lose, they could drop down to six if ECR has a couple wins coming up. But NVMI, better section record, is why they have the fifth spot. That said, the bottom three remains exactly the same. Hollywood beat Westchester again this week, a key win for them. More games coming up for the bottom three. They kind of play each other, so it's really hard to differentiate between them in terms of head-to-head wins, with Westchester beating up on Jordan and then Hollywood beating up on Westchester. So once they play in the playoffs, maybe there'll be some teams from the cellar coming up and playing in the championship, potentially. Who knows, folks? But right now, it just looks like Birmingham, ECR, the rest of these top-flight squads are going to stay at the top. That said, let's get to some scores from around the section. Birmingham, 17-5 over ECR. That's why they have the number three spot in the section. Palisades, 19-5 over Hamilton, as we mentioned. NVMI, 13-3 over Westchester. Birmingham, 13-8 over Long Beach Poly. And then Viewpoint with a 20-10 win over ECR. Hollywood, 6-4 over Westchester. NVMI, 12-3 over Jordan. And then Palisades squeaked out a two-goal win over MiraCosta, 15-13. Royal, 15-7 over ECR. Birmingham, 15-7 over Voss. Then Hamilton, 20-17 over Voss. So not a lot of section play thus far this past week. This week, though, like this week that we're talking about it ahead of us, that'll be a time when we see teams playing teams, Hamilton Palisades, the whole bit coming on this week. So we'll have that for next week's podcast. But right now, my game ball goes to a guy from Palisades. He doesn't get a lot of credit because he doesn't score goals, but rather saves them. Abner Santiago of Palisades gets the game ball for me this week. The senior goalie has been lights out this season in the city section. And Palisades' last three city section games, he has held opposing scores to just 12 goals overall. 4 goals a game. Unbelievable for the goalie. So Abner Santiago, for your slick saves, you get a game ball for me. As for the picks, our favorite time of the podcast, we got 3 games on the slate. Birmingham against Hamilton. Voss against NVMI twice. And then we have Oak Park versus Palisades at Pally on Saturday. So for the first game, Birmingham versus Hamilton, I'm going to have to go with Birmingham. I think that right now, Birmingham, they have a better non-conference schedule than Hamilton. And I thought that they competed a little bit better against Palisades than Hamilton did. So I see Birmingham taking that one. And then for Voss against NVMI, I see Voss both times just because earlier this year, Voss has shown a better record overall. At home, though, it could depend on both teams, but we'll see come Wednesday as well as later this week. Oak Park versus Palisades on Saturday. Going to have to go with Oak Park, unfortunately. I think that their non-conference record has proved that they could be the better team, although Palisades, they've had a couple wins against these Southern Section teams. We'll see come Saturday. Palisades, they're the number one team, though, in the section for sure. So Palisades stays number one on the boys' side, and guess what, folks? They stay number one on the girls' side as well. Let's get into it. The top 8 for the girls' side goes Palisades at 1, Birmingham at 2, Hamilton number 3, then El Camino Real at 4, Voss at 5, and NVMI at 6. As we mentioned in an earlier podcast, Hollywood and Westchester, their seasons are done. They couldn't field enough players, therefore they have forfeited the rest of their schedule. So it's the top 6 in this week's podcast. And just like the boys, as we said, Palisades, the number one team in the section, they had a big win over Birmingham. And in that game, it was back and forth, back and forth. 13-9 eventually was the final in that one. And the Dolphins, they shut down the big score for Birmingham, Zella Bedouin. And it was pretty close in the second half. That's when Birmingham started to come back. We've seen Palisades, they've got out hot in the first half, but then they start to let up in the second half. So we saw in that second half that Birmingham started to come back, but ultimately the goal scoring from that first half, too much for Birmingham to overcome. So Palisades, they get the number one spot. Looking at some scores from the rest of the section, Birmingham went 20-5 over Voss. And then Palisades with a 12-10 win over Beverly Hills last week. ECR went 15-1 over NVMI. As we mentioned, Palisades with the win over Birmingham. And the lights have gone out here at ECR, but we're going to continue with the podcast. Hamilton with an 8-5 win over ECR. Kate with a 12-8 win over Birmingham. Royal 20-2 over ECR. And then Hamilton 14-3 over Voss. So even though the lights are out, we're still going to continue with the podcast here from ECR. And so looking overall at Birmingham, they may have lost to Palisades, but that does not mean that they don't have a lot of talent, because they certainly do. They're able to compete all week this week with their non-conference schedule. And then also with a huge win over Voss, 20-5. That's not an easy thing to do for sure. So Hamilton stays at that 3 spot because they beat ECR 8-5. Because they also have competed with some of the top teams like Birmingham and like Palisades this year. So the game ball for me on the girls' side, it comes from a player from ECR. Number 24, Weckhurst, the mid/attack. She's been unreal. We saw multiple goals from her tonight as well, making great defensive plays. So for ECR, Weckhurst, you get a game ball for me. You've been playing outstanding. We saw on the road, at home, regardless of where you are, you've been playing great, so give you a little shout-out there. And with that, now let's head into some picks. For Voss versus NVMI, I'm going to have to pick Voss. I think this year the head-to-head record shows that Voss is the better of the team. They also competed, interestingly enough, against Palisades in that game, so I'm going to pick Voss in that one. Birmingham taking on ECR. Tough one on Thursday for sure. It's going to be Birmingham. Birmingham looks like the number 2 team in the section for sure. They kept it close with Palisades, and that is not an easy task. So I'm going to take Birmingham in that one. And then a rematch. Pally versus Birmingham at Birmingham. I'm actually, interestingly enough, I'm going to take Birmingham in that one. I'm going with the upset. I think Birmingham right now, they've had a lot of streaky play, but they're on a hot streak, folks. They're able to compete on the road against Birmingham. I think they come back at home and maybe pull out the upset. We'll see. Of course, tonight it was a 9-4 win for Palisades over ECR. And in this one, ECR kept it 4-3 at half, as Coach Ramirez mentioned in the interview. So I think right now that Palisades, their defense is not really showing up the way it should, and their offense really hasn't scored goals in the first half like they usually do. And taking a look at some of the highlights from this game tonight, folks, Palisades, they started out pretty cold offensively. They got 4 goals in the first half, but after that, they were essentially silent. They let El Camino Real come back into the game. In the second half, they scored early, and they kind of held on defensively, but Palisades only winning 9-4 over El Camino Real. Maybe Birmingham can kind of pull an upset here. Remains to be seen, but with that, since the lights are out here, we're going to take lights out on the podcast. Thank you so much for watching. For all of us here at the Southern California Prep Insider, I'm Keith DeMolder. This has been the LA City Section Lacrosse Podcast. Thanks so much for watching. Take it easy, folks. We'll see you next week. I talked with head coach Edgar Ramirez for ECR after their 9-4 loss about what he thought his team could have done better and maybe looking towards some playoff predictions. Let's take a look at the interview. Welcome back to the podcast. After a 9-4 unfortunate loss to Palisades, I'm here with El Camino Real head coach Edgar Ramirez. So, Edgar, a tough loss, but I'm sure there were some positives. What'd you feel about this game?
It's a tough loss coming back from 4-0 to 4-3, and then second half they get early goals in. But we're still learning. We're still growing. Just got to take the positives and move from that.
So, you guys, you came back from 4-0, as you said, 4-3 at the half. What was the mentality going into halftime?
Just having a strong start. I feel like that's what bit us in the butt a little bit. We keep having slow starts the past couple games, and then teams get on us, get goals in, and then it's a climb uphill, and it's harder than, you know, having a strong start, getting goals in your favor early on, so on and so forth. So we just got to figure out how to avoid having slow starts and then going from there.
So this season, it's been up and down, so to speak. What are you guys looking forward to towards the second half of the year?
Just keep working, honestly. Working on basics, learning the rules. I feel like we keep getting different definitions of rules, but what can you do? Like I said, just work on positives and then build the confidence up.
Right. And what specifically can you point to as a positive from tonight's game?
Tonight, being able to come back, or actually being able to somewhat keep up with a team like Palisades. I mean, they've had a program. Just learn from what they do.
Right, right. And it's your first year here at this program, first year of girls lacrosse at El Camino Real. How does it feel to kind of have your bearings a little bit in introducing a new sport here to the school?
It's good. It's a learning process for the team and myself as well. But what I look at is that they're interested. If they're interested, then there's something to build on. Stay positive, just keep growing the program.
Awesome. Is there anything you're looking forward to come playoffs maybe? Is there any things you guys are kind of going to work on in practice?
We got to focus on Birmingham Thursday first and see what happens with that.
Awesome. Well, a 9-4 loss, unfortunate. But El Camino Real, they're headed towards the playoffs. They got a big game against Birmingham.